So we had this young lady, four children. One was school age. The other three, not in school. She had made a stupid choice when she was young, like we all have. She got a DWI. She was unable to pay that DWI ticket, so she lost her license. She had no car, no license. So she was looking at about $1,000 to fix that situation, just to be able to get her license back. And then the SR22 insurance would be $150, $200 a month. We were helping with her utilities, and we'd helped the maximum time that we could help. Had the idea, and I called her and I asked permission if I could ask the school that the elementary child, school-age child attends, if they would help. And she said it was fine. They told me I needed to talk to the counselor. I talked to the counselor, but first I got his secretary. And she said, well, can I leave him a message and what this is regards to? So I just kind of briefly told her, that we were going to ask for help for one of the students' family who has a shutoff notice. They're going to be shut off in 2 days with their utilities. And she very judgmentally said, well, why don't you just get a job like the rest of us? People have this misconception that people can just pick up the phone or go out somewhere and get a job. They don't realize that some of them don't have internet service to do them online. They don't have the skills to do a resume. They don't have interview. A lot of our moms have been being mommies since they were, right out of high school. They never had a whole lot of work experience with no transportation, no car, having to try to figure out how to get three kids to daycare and get to work in time. With no vehicle is a rough barrier. There's always a barrier. It's not black and white. There's a lot of gray. People want to work. They want to help themselves, but sometimes the system's just set up to where they can't.